Unveiling the policy of INEC, the HOD, Voter Education and Publicity in Edo State, Mr. Francis-Ikpefua said that following series of complaints by election observers and the electorate on the delay in between accreditation and voting, which extends the voting process, the commission thought it wise to improve on election process to avoid unnecessary delay. Mr. Ikpefua said the new voting policy will avoid rowdiness at voting centers and make the process less cumbersome for voters, politicians, and INEC staff. He called on politicians to eschew violence before, during, and after the election, as INEC will be free, fair, and credible in the conduct of the election.
The INEC policy right now is, as you come, they will accredit you and you will vote instantly and go away. You don't need to stay behind again and wait for voting again. As you come, they accredit you and you vote. That is accreditation and voting simultaneously. We are using card reader. As you come, APO1, we accredit you, we carry that to see whether your card is RNA card and the thumbprint and all that. You go to APO2, we now give you ballot paper and you vote.
Some residents who spoke on the new voting policy described it as a step in the right direction. They said the intervals in between accreditation and voting in previous election created room for malpractices, violence, and snatching of ballot boxes, and called on INEC to be an unbiased umpire by conducting a conclusive election.
A Edo State election must be conclusive. No matter what happened, they must get it right. Edo people are enlightened people. We don't have rivers around here, so we're having problem with anything. The logistics should be in place, the voting material should be in place, and the people should vote, and our vote must count.
It's a good step in the right direction. Whether or not that will not translate into conclusive election is another kettle of fish, because it's the exit of Jega. It has become very prevalent that elections that have been concluded thereafter have suddenly ended inconclusively, and this has caused worries in the heart of Nigerians. We want to tell INEC, as a matter of fact, that they can only dot their I's and cross their T's.
I know this election is not going to be like the previous election, because a lot of people are so desperate for power. It becomes a do or die affair. So I think this one will reduce the tension. So I think for me, it's a welcome development, and it is the best that INEC has done so far.
Edo State residents and those in diaspora are counting on INEC to conduct free, fair, and credible election in the forthcoming Edo State governorship election slated for 10th of September 2016. Wellington Akodeja reporting.